In this video, we're computing the integral of the square root of 25 minus 4x squared. And this is a classic trigonometric substitution integral. So what we see inside that square root is a constant minus a variable thing squared. So the trig identity that we're targeting here is like a cosine squared theta equals 1 minus sine squared theta. The idea there is that on the right-hand side, I have a constant minus a variable thing squared. And so what we're going to do is make a sine substitution for our x, but we also have to take care of these constants. We have this annoying constant of 25 instead of 1, and we have the 4 stuck on to the x squared. So we have to be a little bit clever with our substitution. We need to choose an x so that when we square it, it's going to cancel out this 4 and also give us a factor of 25, so we can pull that out of the square root and get a 1 for our constant. So it just takes a little bit of guess and check, but what I'm going to do is let x be 5 over 2 times the sine of theta. And you can check that this does the right thing. When I square x, I get 25 fourths sine squared theta. So when I sub that in here, the 4s are going to cancel, and I'm left over with a factor of 25 that I can then factor out of the square root and get a simple 1 minus sine squared theta. So completing our substitution before we rewrite this integral, I need to transform the differential as well. So dx is going to be 5 halves cosine theta times d theta. So now we're ready to transform the integral. So our original integral is going to be equal to a square root of 25 minus, and we've already done the work to see what x squared is going to look like. That's 25 fourths sine squared theta. And when I sub that in, the 4s are going to cancel, so I have a minus 25 sine squared theta. And then our dx is 5 halves cosine theta d theta. So now I can factor a 25 out of the square root, and that leaves me with a 5 outside the square root. And if I combine that with the 5 halves here, I get 25 over 2 for my constant. I'm going to move that whole thing out in front. So I get 25 over 2 times the integral of the square root of 1 minus sine squared. And that was the whole point of this substitution. That 1 minus sine squared can be replaced with a cosine squared. Okay, then that's multiplied by an additional factor of cosine theta, and then d theta. So now we take advantage of this trig identity and rewrite 1 minus sine squared as cosine squared. And when we take the square root of that, we just get cosine. So now we have a cosine theta times cosine theta, and that gives us cosine squared theta. Well, this is a classic trigonometric integral that requires the use of a power-reducing identity. Cosine squared can be expressed as 1 half times the quantity 1 plus cosine of 2 theta. Again, that identity comes with a factor of 1 half. If I pull that out in front, I get 25 fourths. So now each term in this integrand is quickly guessable. The antiderivative of 1 is just theta, and the antiderivative of cosine 2 theta is just 1 half sine 2 theta. So if you're not used to just quickly guessing an antiderivative like this, the 1 half is there to take care of what the chain rule does. And if I differentiate 1 half sine 2 theta, I just get the cosine of 2 theta, and then the chain rule produces a factor of 2 from differentiating the interior function, and it cancels the 1 half, getting us back to where we started. So the indefinite integral is complete, and I should put a plus C on there. Now it would be nice if that was the end of the problem. Unfortunately, our original integral was given to us in terms of x, and we should express the final answer in terms of x as well. So at this point, we have to go back to our original substitution. We said let x be 5 halves sine theta, and we need to solve for theta so we can plug that into our final expression in terms of x. So to solve this for theta, I'll multiply by 2 fifths on both sides, and I get 2x over 5 is equal to sine theta. And solving for theta there means theta is the inverse sine of 2x over 5. So now I have to substitute that in. And so for this first term, I get an inverse sine of 2x over 5. So that part is finished. Unfortunately, over here in the second term, I have the sine of twice the angle whose sine is 2x over 5. And while we can always compute a trig function of an inverse trig function, I don't know what to do with a trig function of twice an inverse trig function. So unfortunately, we're going to have to back up here and use a trig identity on the sine of 2 theta. So we remember this identity that the sine of 2 theta is 2 times the sine of theta times the cosine of theta. That 2 is going to cancel the 1 half out in front. So I end up with just a sine theta cosine theta. And of course, there's a plus c hanging around here. So now we're going to sub in our theta. Again, that's the inverse sine of 2x over 5. And when I sub that into this first term, the sine of the inverse sine of 2x over 5, the sine function is just going to undo the inverse sine function, and it gives me 2x over 5. So that part's fine. The part that's going to take some work is the cosine of the angle whose sine is 2x over 5. So whenever we have a trig function of an inverse trig function, we should be able to express that as a nice algebraic function. And my favorite way to do it is with a little geometric construction. So we draw a right triangle, and what we're trying to do here is visualize the angle whose sine is 2x over 5. So there it is. And that's actually the theta that we're talking about. It's the angle whose sine is 2x over 5, and the easiest way to get that done is to make the opposite side 2x and the hypotenuse 5. Okay, so now we're looking at the angle whose sine is 2x over 5, and what we need is the cosine of this angle. That means we need to guess this adjacent side. With a little bit of practice, this does just become a guess and check process. What we're trying to do is make sure that these sides satisfy the Pythagorean theorem. So I need to guess the thing that I square to add 4x squared to get 5 squared. So that's a square root of 25 minus 4x squared. If I square that, I get 25 minus 4x squared. And then I add to that the square of the other leg, that's 4x squared. And I'm checking to see if that's equal to the square of the hypotenuse, which is 25. Yeah, the negative 4x squared and positive 4x squared cancel, and it works out. Now, if you're not comfortable with the guess and check method, and again, I highly encourage you to practice it because you'll pick it up pretty quick. You can always just give a name to this adjacent side and then write down the Pythagorean theorem and then solve for that unknown side. So here I called the unknown side question mark. And to solve for that, I just have to subtract this 4x squared from both sides and take the square root. And I end up with the same answer, the square root of 25 minus 4x squared. Okay, so now we figured out what the cosine of the angle whose sine is 2x over 5 is, and we're going to sub that in. And I'm going to go ahead and distribute the 25 fourths as I work. So we have 25 fourths inverse sine of 2x over 5 plus a 25 fourths times 2x over 5 times the cosine of this angle. So that's going to be adjacent over hypotenuse. And I get square root 25 minus 4x squared over 5 for that guy. And then we have a plus c. So the first term is taken care of. In the second term, I can cancel this 25 with these two factors of 5, and I can cancel a factor of 2, leaving me with a 2 in the denominator. So we're ready to write our final answer now, and that's 25 fourths inverse sine 2x over 5 plus a 1 half x square root of 25 minus 4x squared plus c, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.